In the final lecture, we are going to discuss the topic of sensitivity analysis. Sensitivity is going to give us information on how the acoustic response at some point of interest is going to depend on some design variables associated with our structure. Therefore, we'll be able to identify which design variables to change and how to change them in order to reduce the radiated noise. In the overview, we are going to identify the two steps which are involved in computing sensitivities, and then we are going to get into more details on the first step, which is the structural dynamic sensitivity, which identifies how the structural vibration depends on our design variables. In the second step, we are going to explain how we compute the dependency of the acoustic response at the point of interest to the velocity boundary conditions, and then finally, how we combine all this information to compute the structural acoustic sensitivity, which indicates how the acoustic response at the point of interest depends on the structural design variables. Finally, we are going to go over a simple example problem which will demonstrate how the sensitivity analysis works and how we can interpret the results. The structural acoustic sensitivity computation is a two-step process. The structural acoustic sensitivity can be defined as the information of how the acoustic response at some point of interest is going to depend on a structural design variable. And in order to compute that, we need to utilize a general purpose finite element program and compute how the structural vibration is going to depend on the structural design variables of interest, and then utilize a general purpose acoustics code and compute how the acoustic response at the point of interest is going to depend on the velocity boundary conditions. Then we can use the chain rule in differentiation and combine the two parts of the information in order to compute the structural acoustic sensitivity, which indicates how the acoustic response at the point of interest will depend on the structural design variable. Then we can use that information to determine how we want to modify our structure in order to reduce the noise at the point of interest. First, we are going to discuss the theoretical background which is associated with computing the structural dynamic sensitivity. What we are interested in computing is how the structural vibration depends on some designated structural design variable. And we can utilize as design variable the thickness of a plate or some cross-sectional properties of beam elements as area or inertia properties. We can also define as design variables other parameters like material properties. What we are going to be computing from our equations is how the displacement of the vibration depends on the design variable, and then we can use the equation of the harmonic motion to associate this information to what we finally want to compute, which is how the velocity of the structural vibration is going to change with respect to our design variables. In the computations of the structural dynamic sensitivities, we are going to utilize the discrete equation of motion. This equation associates the displacement of the vibration with the forces, the mechanical forces which comprise the excitation, and the matrices which describe our structural system as the mass matrix, the damping matrix, and the stiffness matrix. In these sensitivity computations, we are going to make the assumption that the force which comprises the excitation is not going to depend on the structural design variables, and that's a very valid assumption for harmonic motion. By differentiating equation 2 with respect to a structural design variable, we obtain a term which is the dynamic sensitivity, which indicates how the structural vibration will depend on the design variable. And this term is multiplied with the matrices of the original system. And then we also get a second term, which includes the changes in the structural system due to the design variable. And that term is multiplied with the baseline vibration response. Then, from this equation, we can directly solve for the sensitivity vector, which is the information we are looking for and tells us how the vibration is going to depend on the structural design variable. Here we are going to explain more in detail the different parameters which are involved in computing the dynamic sensitivity. First, we need information from the baseline structure in terms of the mass, damping, and stiffness matrix of the baseline model. Then we also need information of how the different matrices, the mass, damping, and stiffness matrix, are going to change with respect to the design variable. So this term here indicates how our structural model is going to change with respect to the design variable. Finally, we also need information about the baseline response. Therefore, we can notice here that the dynamic sensitivity is going to depend not only on the changes which are introduced in our structural model, but also on the baseline response of the structural model. And this is important to keep in mind. For example, if we consider a typical optimization process where we have to go through multiple analysis steps, and at every step we modify our design in order to try to reach an optimum design. In such a process, we would have to compute the dynamic sensitivity at every analysis step. And in such a case, we are going to utilize the information for the vibration from the previous step in computing the dynamic sensitivity. And this is important to keep in mind because, as we are going to discuss later, the acoustic sensitivity does not follow a similar pattern, but it's rather independent of the velocity boundary conditions which are imposed at each step of such an optimization process. Here we are going to discuss the theoretical information which is associated with deriving the acoustic sensitivity. The acoustic sensitivity indicates how the response at the data recovery point is going to change with respect to the velocity boundary condition. As we have discussed in the lecture series, we can utilize either the direct or the indirect boundary element method in acoustic computations. And in a similar manner, we can utilize either the direct or the indirect formulation in computing the acoustic sensitivity. Here, just for simplicity, we are going to discuss the equations which are associated with deriving the acoustic sensitivity in the direct boundary element method. And as we have indicated before, the acoustic boundary element method is a two-step process. First, we compute some primary variables on the surface of our model with respect to the imposed boundary conditions. For instance, if we have a vibrating object and we know the velocity boundary conditions, we can compute in the direct boundary element method the distribution of the pressure on the surface of the model. And the equation that allows us to do that also involves some acoustic matrices which depend on the geometry of our model, the frequency of analysis, and the acoustic medium. In the direct boundary element method, the acoustic response at some data recovery point of interest is computed based on the distribution of the acoustic pressure on the surface of the model and on the distribution of the velocity boundary conditions. We also have two vectors which depend on the geometry of the model, the location of our data recovery point, the frequency of analysis, and the properties of the acoustic medium. The objective now is to compute how the acoustic response at the data recovery point is going to change with respect to the velocity boundary conditions. And we need to compute that for every element, that is, how the acoustic response at the data recovery point is going to change with respect to the velocity boundary condition imposed on every element of our boundary element model. Here with subscript I, we indicate the velocity which is associated with the ith element. In order to compute the acoustic sensitivity, we need to differentiate equation 5 with respect to the velocity boundary condition of the ith element. And in this case, we are going also to need information of how the distribution of the pressure on the surface of the model is going to depend on the velocity boundary condition of the ith element. Therefore, we also need to differentiate equation 4 with respect to the velocity of the ith element in order to compute that. By differentiating equation 4 with respect to the velocity boundary condition of the ith element, we are able to compute how the pressure distribution on the surface of our boundary element model is going to change with respect to the velocity boundary condition of the ith element. We need to note here that the identity vector results from differentiating the vector of the velocity boundary conditions with respect to the velocity of a particular element. Once we have computed the expression of how the distribution of the pressures is going to change with respect to the velocity of a particular element, then we can differentiate equation 5 with respect to the velocity of the ith element and utilize the expression that we computed from equation 7 to finally compute how the acoustic response at a point of interest is going to depend on the velocity of the ith element. We need to note here that this expression on the right-hand side only includes vectors or matrices which depend on the geometry of the problem, the frequency of analysis, and the material properties of the acoustic medium. The derivation of the acoustic sensitivity for the direct boundary element method can also be utilized with the multi-zone approach in the direct boundary element method. Also, for the indirect method, the approach of deriving the acoustic sensitivity, how the acoustic response at the point of interest is going to depend on a velocity boundary condition on the surface of the boundary element model, is similar to the process which we followed for the direct method. In that case too, the expression for the acoustic sensitivity is going to include elements of the boundary element formulation, and similar to the direct boundary element method, the acoustic sensitivity as computed from the indirect is only going to depend on the geometry of the model and the location of our data recovery point, the frequency of analysis, and the properties of the acoustic medium. The fact that the acoustic sensitivity is independent on the velocity boundary conditions for both the direct and the indirect method is important in an optimization process. As we discussed when we were reviewing the structural dynamic sensitivities, in an optimization process we have multiple steps, and at every step we perform a new analysis that allows us to compute the noise that is getting radiated for that particular state of the design. However, because the acoustic sensitivity is independent of the velocity boundary conditions, therefore it is independent of the vibration that we have at that particular state of the design, we do not need to compute the acoustic sensitivity at every part of the optimization process. The acoustic sensitivity computations for both the direct and indirect boundary element methods have been implemented into the Comet Acoustics software package. Here we are going to cover the theoretical information about deriving the structural acoustic sensitivity and also on how we can interpret this information in deciding the structural modifications which will reduce the radiated noise. The structural acoustic sensitivity indicates how the acoustic response at a point of interest will depend on some structural design variable. In order to compute this, we utilize the chain rule in differentiation and information that we computed previously from the structural dynamic sensitivity and the acoustic sensitivity. Since the information for the structural dynamic sensitivity must be expressed in terms of the normal velocity, we must take an extra step and convert the structural dynamic sensitivities in the normal direction for each element. Here we are going to review the mathematical relationship which allows us to convert the structural dynamic sensitivity into sensitivity information for the normal velocity on every element. In order to achieve that, we take the dot product of the structural dynamic sensitivity times the unit normal on a particular element, and we integrate over that element and we divide with the area of the element. In this manner, we can come up with an average value for the change in the normal velocity of the element with respect to the structural design variable. The structural acoustic sensitivity, it is a complex number and therefore needs to be interpreted appropriately. In order to be able to do that, we need to take into account the value for the baseline acoustic response. Let's assign some numerical values for the baseline acoustic response and see how we can interpret the acoustic sensitivity results using a simple example problem. The baseline acoustic response can be expressed in terms of the real value of the pressure and the imaginary value of the pressure. And then let's assign some numerical values for the real part and for the imaginary part. And in this case, we are going to assign the same value of 10 units to both real and imaginary part. The structural acoustic sensitivity is also a complex number, and let's try to also assign some numerical values for the real part and for the imaginary part of the structural acoustic sensitivity. If now we introduced a change in our structural design variable equal to 1 unit, then we can see through this simple numerical example that the value that we are going to get for the change in the real part of the pressure is going to be equal to 1, and the change that we are going to get for the imaginary part of the pressure is going to be equal to minus 0.1. Therefore, now we can take into account what we consider to be values for the baseline acoustic response. So, if the change in the real part of the pressure is 1 and the baseline response is 10, then the new estimated real part of the pressure is going to be 11. On the other hand, we have minus 0.1 as change in the imaginary part of the pressure, and we have 10 as baseline response for the imaginary part. Therefore, the new estimated part is going to be 9.9. So we see that a positive change in the design variable rather introduced an increase in the magnitude of the pressure, because the real part changed more than the imaginary part, and it changed towards increasing the pressure. From this we can deduct that if we want to reduce the acoustic response, then we need to introduce a negative change in our design variable. In this simple example problem, we are going to demonstrate how we can utilize the structural acoustic sensitivity information in order to reduce the noise that is getting radiated from a vibrating steel plate. The objective is to redesign the plate in order to reduce the noise that is getting radiated at a particular data recovery point of interest. In order to achieve that, we divide the plate into 4 different areas, and we assign the thickness of each one of those areas to comprise 1 design variable. The plate is simply supported all around 4 edges, and it is mounted on a rigid box which is depicted with the blue color. We are going to discuss in a little bit more detail the physical description of this particular problem. The box on which the flexible plate is mounted is rigid, and the plate is excited by placing a point force in the middle of it. We are using air as acoustic medium, and we compute the acoustic response at the data recovery point, which is located in front of the plate. In this example problem, we are going to utilize the direct boundary element method for our acoustic computations. The entire box with the front elastic plate and the rigid lateral sides and back side is going to be part of our acoustic boundary element model. In order to perform the structural acoustic sensitivity analysis, we need to compute 2 types of sensitivities: the structural dynamic sensitivities, and we utilize MSC-Nastran for this computation, and the acoustic sensitivities, which are carried out by Comet Acoustics. Finally, once we determine from the structural acoustic sensitivity information how to modify the structural properties of the plate, we are going to perform another analysis on the redesigned plate in order to evaluate whether we were actually able to reduce the noise or not by implementing the design changes that the structural acoustic sensitivity analysis indicated. Some more information with respect to the physical modeling of the elastic plate. We are going to utilize plate elements in our structural finite element model, and we are going to apply a point load located in the middle of the plate. We are going to perform the analysis at a single frequency of 100 Hz, and we are going to utilize the direct frequency response method, since we are only interested in computing the vibration of the plate for a single frequency. If we were interested in performing vibration computations over an entire frequency range, then in that case maybe the modal approach might have been more attractive. But since we are only interested in a single frequency, we are going to use the direct frequency response method. For the boundary element model, we are going to utilize the direct boundary element method, and we are going to generate the acoustic model by covering with surface elements the entire outer surface of the box. Here we are going to describe the solution procedure used for this particular example problem. The preliminary work involves generating a structural finite element model, which we are going to utilize to compute the structural vibration of the plate, an acoustic boundary element model, which we are going to utilize in our acoustic computations, and also we are going to need a data recovery model where we are going to visualize the results from the acoustic analysis. Regular finite element preprocessors have been used to generate those three models. Before performing the acoustic sensitivity analysis, we have completed the structural frequency response analysis for the baseline design and also the structural dynamic sensitivity computations. The acoustic sensitivity computations example starts here, and the first thing to do is import our acoustic boundary element model into Comet Vision and define and save some desired views that will allow us to view the model and the results easily. We are going to assign material properties for the acoustic medium, and in this case we selected to assign material properties for air. Then we are going to set the analysis parameter. We are going to indicate that we would like to perform a direct boundary element analysis and in particular a sensitivity analysis, and we are going to output from Comet Vision a data file for Comet Acoustics. In this data file we are going to add information about the data recovery node with respect to which we are going to compute the acoustic sensitivity. And then we are going to launch a Comet Acoustics run in order to compute the acoustic sensitivities. Once the analysis has been completed, we can import the results into Comet Vision and visualize the distribution of the sensitivities over the surface of our boundary element model. We can also combine the results from the structural dynamic sensitivities and the acoustic sensitivities which we just computed in order to compute finally the structural acoustic sensitivity, which will indicate how the acoustic response at the data recovery point will depend on the four structural design variables. We will review then those results in a tabular form, and then we are going to run the acoustic response analysis using Comet Acoustics for both the baseline and the modified design. And then we are going to post-process the results within Comet Vision in order to make a judgment how much improvement we were able to obtain by modifying our structural finite element model. Here we have a summary of the results from the structural acoustic sensitivity computations. We can see very easily that the highest values for the structural acoustic sensitivities have been produced for design variable number one, and that is the thickness of the outer zone of elements in our finite element model. By taking into account also the baseline values for the acoustic response at the data recovery point, we can conclude that in order to reduce the acoustic response at the point of interest, we need to reduce the thickness of the outer zone of elements in our structural finite element model. These are the results from the acoustic sensitivity computations. This plot indicates how the acoustic response at the data recovery point of interest depends on the velocity boundary conditions for the different elements in our boundary element model. For instance, these results indicate that the acoustic response at the point of interest is more sensitive to velocities applied on the front of the box rather than velocities applied on the lateral surfaces or at the back. However, we need to combine these results from the acoustic sensitivity computations with results from the structural dynamic sensitivity in order to derive the combined structural dynamic sensitivities which we reviewed in the previous page. These are the results from the acoustic analysis for the baseline plate. We are plotting the sound pressure levels on a data recovery plane which is located in front of the vibrating plate. The acoustic sensitivities have been computed for the point in the middle of the data recovery plane, since this particular point has the highest acoustic response. The results from the structural acoustic sensitivity analysis indicated that the best way to reduce the noise at the data recovery point of interest is to reduce the thickness of the outer zone of elements in our structural finite element model. After implementing this change in the structural finite element model, we perform the structural vibration analysis and the acoustic analysis again, and we compare the results between the baseline and the modified design for the acoustic response. As the sensitivity analysis indicated, we managed through the change introduced in the structural finite element model to reduce the noise at the point of interest. And in this case, we can also observe that overall, on the entire data recovery surface, the radiated noise was reduced. Therefore, our redesigned structure is quieter.